Dear teachers, when you interact with your learners in the classroom, you may find that all learners are not same. But if you go towards the traditional psychological practices, most of the time, whenever we talk about the intelligence of our students or the intelligence of any individual, we talk in terms of intelligence quotient or IQ. But there are psychologists who do not subscribe the idea of IQ. Because IQ is a score, and you cannot label each and every individual with a particular score, that too based on any standardized tests. So when this IQ was growing up, the concept of IQ was growing up, there was a psychologist who contradicted the concept of IQ. He actually said that a single number or a score on an IQ test cannot adequately represent the complex and diverse complexities of human being. So what he proposed that people have different types of intelligence, and his name was Gardner. Today we are going to discuss about the theory of multiple intelligence proposed by Gardner. I am Dr. Gaurav Singh from School of Education, and I will tell you some basic assumptions and basic points of his theory. Howard Gardner actually introduced the term of multiple intelligence in 1983 when he wrote his very famous book, Frames of Mind, The Theory of Multiple Intelligence. In his book, he initially identified 7 types of intelligences. Later on, he added one more, then it became 8, and nowadays these are 9. But Gardner was firm believer that intelligence cannot be same. Why? He defined intelligence as a biophysical potential to the process information that can be activated in a cultural setting to solve problems or create products that are of value in a culture. So Gardner's view of intelligence was culture specific and contextual in nature. He said that whenever someone face a problem within a culture, they try to solve that problem by processing of the information they have, and an individual's potential, the biopsychological potential of that individual, is actually called his or her intelligence. And when Gardner proposed different types of intelligence, he said that each domain which he proposed involves a blend of general G factor, that is the general intelligence factor, some cognitive abilities along with G, and in some cases he also proposed that some non-cognitive abilities or personality characteristics also contribute to the intelligence. So what Gardner proposes? Gardner actually proposed 9 types of intelligence. You can see that it was verbal linguistics, logico-mathematical, visual-spatial, musical, bodily kinesthetics, interpersonal, intrapersonal, naturalistic, and recently he added existentialistic, though in many books it is still not there, and many books are talking about only 8 types, but Gardner proposed and added the 9th. Even in 2006 he said, I want to add some more which may be added later. Let us discuss one by one. You know, have you ever interacted with any writer or any journalist or any lawyer, a teacher, a poet? Can you try to identify some common characteristics among these people? I mean, what a writer has, a journalist also have, a lawyer also have, a teacher also have, a poet also have. If you try to analyze these people, you will find that these people are very good in remembering the written and spoken information. The people in such profession enjoy reading and writing a lot. दीज पीपल आर वेरी गुड इन डिबेटिंग और गिविंग पर्सुएसिव स्पीचेस लाइक लॉयर्स राइटर्स एंड दीज पीपल हैव अ वेरी गुड एबिलिटी और यू कैन से वेरी गुड कैपेसिटी टू एक्सप्लेन द थिंग्स वेल बाई यूजिंग देयर लैंग्वेज बाई स्पीकिंग और बाई राइटिंग एंड समटाइम्स दे यूज ह्यूमर ऑल्सो वेन दे आर टेलिंग सम स्टोरीज. So now you again recall a writer, a poet, a lawyer, a teacher. Can you identify these characteristics in them? If you can identify, then these people have verbal linguistics type of intelligence, which is first in the list of Gardner. So when you identify students in your class who can learn best through reading, through hearing or seeing the words, through speaking or writing or discussing and debating, then you can say that these people have the capacity to become a good writer, a good teacher, a good poet, a good liar, and these people have verbal linguistics type of intelligence. But it doesn't mean that they don't have other types of intelligences. They have. But this factor is more prominent as compared to rest of the factors in their intelligence, and it contributes a lot. Similarly, when you see a scientist, when you see a mathematician, a computer programmer, an engineer, or an accountant, can you try to again identify some common characteristics between these people? Means a scientist, mathematician, computer programmer, engineering or accountant. If you try to identify, you will find that such people are very good in reasoning. These people like recognizing patterns and logically they try to analyze the problems. These people have a very good conceptual ability to think about numbers, relationships, patterns. They have very excellent problem solving skill. They enjoy thinking about abstract ideas. They love to conduct scientific experiments. And they are very good at solving the complex computation. Now, think about these characteristics. And again, think about the people, scientist, mathematician, computer programmer, engineer, or an accountant. You will find that these characteristics are very common among such type of people. So, if you find a learner in class who love to work with pattern and relationship, who try to learn through classification, who are very much engaged in working with abstract ideas, then you can say that these people have logico-mathematical kind of intelligence, which is second type of intelligence in the list of Gardner. Next type is, if you see any artist, if you see any surgeon, a photographer, a sailor, a painter, what you find? What common characteristics you can identify between an artist, photographer, engineer, sailor, surgeon, or painter? If you try to analyze, you will find that these people are very good in visualizing things. These people have excellent command over directions. They are very good in interpreting maps, charts, videos, pictures. They are very good in putting puzzles together. Such people enjoy drawing, painting, and the visual arts, and they recognize the patterns easily. So these characteristics you will find among the artists, photographers, engineers, painters, sailor, surgeon, and the people involved in similar type of professions or vocations. So if you find any learner who love to work with pictures and colors, who is very good in visualizing things and who love to learn through visualization and drawing, you can say such learner has visual spatial type of intelligence. So each type of intelligence has its some specific characteristics, as well as you will find that that type of intelligence is prominent or more in some people who are involved in some specific vocations or professions. Let us talk the fourth one. What common you can identify in a musician, in a composer, music composer, in a singer, or in a music teacher? If you analyze the characteristics of these people, like the musicians, the music composers, the singers, the music teachers, you will find that these people are very good at thinking in patterns, rhythms, and sounds. These people have a strong appreciation for music. These people often found very good at musical compositions and performances. They enjoy singing and playing musical instruments. And not only they enjoy singing and playing musical instruments, they basically recognize the musical patterns and tones very easily. They are very good in remembering the songs and melodies, and they have very rich understanding of musical structure, notes, rhythm, and all these things. So the people who have such type of intelligence, this is called musical intelligence. If you find students or learners in your class who love to learn through rhythm, who like melodies, who like singing, who love to listen to music and melodies, you can say that such students have musical type of intelligence more prominently than other types of intelligence. Similarly, if you see a dancer, a sculptor, an actor, or the builder who builds the buildings, what common characteristics you can identify between these different people? You can identify that these people are very good at body movements. They are very good in performing actions and physical control. They have very excellent eye-hand coordination and dexterity. They are very good in dancing, sports. They enjoy creating things with their own hands. And they have very excellent physical coordination. They tend to remember things by doing rather by hearing or seeing. So if you find any learner in your class who love to learn through touching, through movement, by processing the knowledge through bodily sensations, you can say that learner has bodily kinesthetic type of intelligence. So that learner have a capacity that in future he or she may become a good dancer, a good sculptor, a good actor, or a great builder. So if you see each type, again I'm repeating it, if you see that each type of intelligence has certain specific characteristics, and Gardner proposed that these characteristics are more prominent in every individual and which are different. Now let us move to another type of intelligence. Have you ever seen any psychologist? Have you interacted with him or her? How he or she interact with their customers or the patients or the clients? Or a teacher? Have you interacted with any counselor who do counseling? It's not about mental illness counseling. It's about vocational counseling also, professional counseling also, educational counseling also. In a school, you may have certain counselors. Or you must have seen a salesperson who pursue to sell the things which he or she has, or a politician. If you try to identify the common characteristics among these people, a psychologist, a counselor, a salesperson, or a politician, what you will find? That these people are very good in understanding and interacting with other people. These people have skills to assess the emotions. They have skills to motivate you. They have skills to assess your desires, your intentions which are around you. They are very good in communicating verbally. And also they are skilled in non-verbal communications. They try to see any situation with different perspectives. They create positive relationship with you. Like a politician creates a relationship with the public. A psychologist creates a relationship with the client. A counselor creates a relationship with his or her client. And they are very good in resolving conflicts if it occurs, especially in groups. So this ability or this type of intelligence is known as interpersonal intelligence. And if you find that the learners in your class, if there is any learner who learn best through sharing, through comparing, through relating things, by interviewing or cooperating with the peers and teachers and other members of the society, then you can see that that individual, that learner has interpersonal type of personality. Let us see what a philosopher has, what a theorist has, what a scientist has, or sometimes writers also. If you try to analyze these people, means the philosophers, the writers, the theorists, the scientists, what you will find that these people are very good at being aware of their own emotions, their own feelings, their own motivations. They tend to enjoy the self-reflections and self-analysis. Sometimes you may find them involved in daydreaming, or they are exploring relations with others. They are very good in assessing their personal strengths. They are very good at analyzing their strengths and weaknesses. They enjoy analyzing different theories and ideas. They have very excellent self-awareness. And they have very clear understanding of the basis of their own motivations and feelings. So you can say that these people believe more in their own analysis, their own understanding. They try to understand their own thought process. Such type of intelligence is called intrapersonal intelligence. And if you find a learner or few learners in your class who learn best when they work alone, who perform better when you give them self-paced projects, who love to have their own personal space, they love to reflect, it means that they have intrapersonal type of intelligence. But what about biologists? What about conservationists? What about a gardener? What about a farmer? They also have intelligence. They may be educated. A farmer may be educated, may not be educated. Or I can say maybe literate or not literate. A gardener may be literate or not literate, but they have intelligence. So what you find common in a biologist, in a conservationist, in a gardener, or in a farmer? If you analyze these people, you will find these people are more in tune with the nature. Such people often show their interest in nurturing and exploring the environment. They learn about different species. They are always aware about the changes in the environment. If they are students, most of them may be more interested in the subjects like agriculture, botany, biology, geology. They are very good in categorizing and cataloging the information. They love outdoor camping, gardening, hiking, and exploring. And if a topic is not having any relationship with the nature, or it is very abstract kind of topic, you will find that such type of people, such type of learner, often feel disconnected and they do not enjoy. So if you find in your class any student or any learner who love to work with nature, who like exploring different things, who always want to learn about plants and natural events, who is always aware about climate changes, who talk about this, who try to connect nature with each and every activity of his or her own. He encourages others to save nature. It means that such people learn best through these activities, and such people or such learners have naturalistic kind of intelligence. Then, as I told you, after these eight, later on Gardner added one more, which is called existentialistic type of intelligence. Actually, he was trying to figure out the spiritual intelligence, and spirituality not in terms of religions. Spirituality means they try to find out a humanistic touch with everything, with nature, with animals, with human beings, with peers. So if you try to, people who are social scientists, spiritualists, or sometimes social worker, what they do? They basically have a very high degree of spiritual intelligence. They have their connection with the people, with the society, with the situation, and also with the circumstances. So they are the people who basically understand a person, a society, a situation, and a circumstance very effectively as compared to others. And such students and such people learn best through social milieu. If they are mixed with the society, if they are the part of the society, they learn better. Because for them, the other self, their own self and the other self is same. They develop a kind of a spiritual connection with everyone. Not only with the living beings, but even with non-living beings. They see life everywhere. They feel pain in the pain of everyone's. They feel pain in the pain of society members. They feel pain in the pain of plants. They feel pain in the pain of any animal or any living or non-living being. And they think that everything which has its existence is like them. So such type of people, Gardner said, are existentialist people, and they have intelligence called existentialistic intelligence. So if you recall what I have discussed about all nine types of intelligence which are proposed by Gardner. And if you try to analyze anyone, any individual with whom you interact around you, it may be a teacher, it may be a doctor, it may be a gardener, it may be a farmer, it may be a bus conductor, it may be a sweeper, it can be anyone who comes around you, and you try to analyze what kind of intelligence that person has. I'm sure if you will analyze with the characteristics explained in this discussion, you will find that some may be verbal linguistics, some may have logico-mathematical abilities, some may be visual spatial, some may be musically intelligent, some may be using bodily kinesthetic things, some may be intrapersonal, few may be interpersonal, few may be naturalistic or existentialistic. And Gardner has said that this classification doesn't mean that one individual has only one type of intelligence. He said that an individual may be a verbal linguistic. It doesn't mean he do not have interest in music. It doesn't mean he do not have interpersonal or intrapersonal abilities. He has or she has. But which type is more prominent, that decides how he or she will perform in his or her life. So Gardner's theory of intelligence is still evolving. And Gardner himself said in 2006 that he want to add more types of intelligence in the list, because as he is working more, he is identifying more types of intelligence among the people. So this theory has broken the jinx that intelligence can be defined only in terms of IQ. IQ scores are not the correct measure of intelligence of every individual, because most of the IQ tests measures your abilities in particular field. If someone is not having a verbal ability, a spatial ability, or a numerical ability, or the reasoning ability, it doesn't mean he or she is not intelligent. Every individual is intelligent in one field or in another. This is the message of Gardner, and this is the message of this session. I hope you have enjoyed it, and you will try to understand what Gardner is saying. You will go and read what Gardner is working and how his theory is growing day by day. Thank you very much.